The function of universities in India today is more than anything else to set the standard of behavior for the cultured among us and to equip young men and women with the intellectual and moral equipment needed for active leadership in all walks of life and throughout the country. We have already seen disappointments and defects enough to make us realize that there is greater need for courage and sacrifice in constructive work than even what was needed and demanded in the struggle for independence. It is a mistake to think that the human mechanism of thinking receives adequate educational help through studies only. Manual work is of the greatest importance in any scheme of education. Do not underestimate manual labor. The restoration to manual work of its proper dignity is a national necessity. In India, it has to be said that we believe in false dignity. We don't carry even our small things ourselves. Do not think I am merely uttering trite and old statements and formulae when I tell you, as a practical man, that a democratically governed state, big or small, will have a government only in the measure of the wisdom and the character of the people and the leaders. Good government cannot be obtained except by the good character of the voters. The organic synthesis that shapes itself in a state with a heterogeneous population is a precious development in national progress and should be looked upon as such by everyone who aspires for great things on behalf of India. Haste certainly makes waste. Clannishness and intrigue will postpone the fulfillment of the aims of democracy. No man is free from vanity. In youth, you grow, and you cannot grow unless you are vigorous, expressive, and more or less thoughtless. Also, if you think too much, you cannot grow. It is only if you are occasionally thoughtless that the cells of the body receive their natural impressions and develop, especially in times of youth. There was no way in life to get away from error except by confession and by praying. There is no need to be morose in order to be useful. Work in a spirit of joyfulness when helping others. A leader is one who guides those who are not educated or experienced in any department of life. Character consists in the automatic behavior, what your reaction is to what happens around you. If you have character, whether you do well in your studies or not, you can still be a leader. About adult suffrage is easy, but adult wisdom is something more difficult. Nothing is useful if you learn it only for yourself and you are unable to express it and give it to others. That is very important. Seedless knowledge is only self-satisfaction. Having gone through 150 years of foreign rule, why should we not conserve the advantages gained by the foreign rule? We should conserve what is good or useful and not destroy. You should learn as quickly and as well as possible so that you may impart what is learned to others. We have changed over from British rule, from bureaucracy to democracy, and I hope we will soon change over from flattery to precise expression. As a matter of fact, I do not believe in astrology. If anyone of you believe in astrology, I would warn you against it. Even if there is something in astrology, it is very unwise to look to the future through the help of the stars. Our efforts are not commensurate with the suffering which we wish to relieve. When errors, difficulties, and delays present themselves to you for observation and criticism, I want you to pay a thought to the other side of the matter and to see how much weight and responsibility are borne by a few people. The mountain path is steep, but we shall go up. Words are dangerous things, the greatest danger being that they make us imagine that we misunderstand things when we really do not understand them. There is all the difference in the world between a conviction of mind which backs your faith in a particular approach to the mystery of the universe, when that conviction is supplemented by arrogance and when it is mitigated by humility. A conviction that is supplemented by humility of approach creates tolerance. A conviction that is strengthened by arrogance creates intolerance. The Gita says, with reference to forms of faith, that every faith leads to Ishvara, and so one should not be proud or arrogant.